"Teach your children well" may have been the favorite line of Don Gregorio Soriano Araneta, dubbed as a Mulave or Mulawin of his country, on the March 10, 1930 edition of the Tribune by the Pulitzer awardee and former United Nations General Assembly President, Mr. Carlos P. Romulo. How inspiring to come across such men during these days when they are so few, when they modestly stay away from the limelight, leaving the kamoting kahoy, the kogon, and the balete to monopolize public attention. The youth of the land, with its dubious standards of leadership, should find in the Mulaves and Tindalos of the race like Don Gregorio Araneta a salutary influence to offset and counterbalance the hold that the tinsel show of ill-acquired glory and wealth has on its immature mind. There is indeed something more substantial, something more permanent than power or riches. But who is Don Gregorio Araneta and why are we talking about him? For starters, he was the first Filipino to be appointed Secretary of Justice and Finance, and also Solicitor General in the 1900s when Filipinos were thought of as incapable of solving the nation's problems on finance. More importantly, he is the father of Salvador Araneta, one of FEATIU's pillars. The teachings of Don Gregorio Araneta became the life's compass of our founder, Dr. Salvador. The third child of Don Gregorio and Carmen Rojas Zaragoza, Salvador vividly recalled the parable comparing a man to a tree that his dad shared with him. He quipped that if a tree starts crooked at the beginning, it will always be crooked, but a tree that starts straight remains straight all its life. As Dr. Salvador puts it, in the formative years, you have a real good chance to mold the character of a person. Try to teach the young unselfishness and love of country. Don Gregorio Araneta, who was a master in the art of advocacy, taught his children and his students to be passionate about justice, charity, and stewardship, to choose honor before glory. To him, what was important in life was not the possession of money, but the command of ideas that shape destinies. To his children, Don Gregorio left a legacy of recognition that during his incumbency, the Department of Justice and Finance earned the highest esteem of the Americans. These ideals from Don Gregorio shaped the values and character of Salvador, a known relentless advocate for the homeless, the unemployed, and for the industrialization of the Philippines. The patriotic spirit and persistent advocacy to Filipino First policy of Salvador prompted him to establish the National Economic Protectionism Association, or NEPA, the oldest non-governmental organization, or NGO, on November 19, 1934. NEPA was created to prioritize and protect local and Filipino-owned industries against dominion by foreign interests and competition. NEPA became a symbol of pride and trademark of products made in the Philippines and by Filipinos. Even though the endeavor of NEPA was interrupted by World War II, its pre-war efforts in raising consciousness of self-reliance to Filipino inventors and businessmen with their families made it easier for them to produce basic and essential commodities out of available materials grown and found locally. No wonder patriotism is one of the core values being ingrained in the minds of every Filipinian. Dr. Salvador was also one of the founders of PRRM, or Philippine Rural Reconstruction Movement, that envisions to empower and develop rural communities by providing training on self-government and on how such communities can sustain themselves globally, nationally, and locally. Don Salvador's marriage to Doña Victoria, the daughter of Eusebio Lopez and Ana Ledesma, who shared his deep involvement in advocacies and social civic causes, in 1927 made a greater impact to society and the Philippines as a whole. One of Victoria's social civic involvements was the creation and management of the Women's Chapter of NEPA, which raised fund and awareness about Filipino First policy among wives of successful Filipino businessmen. Although both were born into affluence, they never turned a blind eye or a deaf ear to the plight of the poor and marginalized. Doña Victoria put up White Cross with the goal of taking care of children whose parents were afflicted or died of tuberculosis. Up to this day, the White Cross still houses orphans or abandoned kids of unwed mothers, indigent families, tuberculosis patients, mentally or physically incapacitated parents, prisoners, or victims of incest or rape. These children are given medical assistance, educational care, and financial support to help them in their early years. Doña Victoria also set up a school for children in Mandaluyong and at one point had catechism classes held in their house, the Villa Victoneta or Victoneta 1933 in Shaw Boulevard.
So for tonight,
San Francisco, and the islands in the Philippines. It later developed into a school that does not only educate aircraft engineers and mechanics, but also those who want to become good civil, maritime, electrical and electronics engineers, successful entrepreneurs, and master mariners and architects. Dr. Salvador's principle of sticking to integrity and remaining righteous was adopted to be one of the five core values of FEATIU today. For him, success without integrity is shallow and empty. Thus, integrity and accountability, which is another attribute of a FEATIUnian, go hand in hand. They also established the Araneta Institute of Agriculture, or AIA, at Hakarian Dairy Farm in San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. AIA was renamed Gregorio Araneta University Foundation, or GAUF, after it was transferred to Malabon. It later became the De La Salle Araneta University, which is the first private agriculture and veterinary medicine school in the country and considered by our founders as their sixth child, where 1/6 of their personal wealth was allocated. Salvador's AIA Biological Laboratories pioneered in animal vaccines, while FEATIU Industries manufactured Philippine-made electric motors. His Republic Soya was first in soybean extraction in the country. He also started the flour industry with Republic Flour Mills, or RFM, Corporation that sits on a 7-hectare property along Pasig River. Under the leadership of our founder, RFM grew and ventured into the production of margarine and cooking oil, then expanding into the manufacture of feeds for hogs, poultry, and other animal feeds through AIA feed mills, while meeting the demands of the appetite of the Filipinos. The creation of FEATIU in Industries, the Araneta Institute of Agriculture, and the FEATIU Bank and Trust Company paved the way for students to demonstrate their skills and talents and to have a market for locally made products. Victoria helped in the endeavors of expanding and managing the industries or businesses that either her husband or both of them started. The tasks of being a mother, businesswoman, and president of a fast-growing FEATIU University never got in her way as she graced every event in the campus from opening of classes to commencement rites. Even when martial law was declared and the couple were in self-exile in Canada, Victoria managed FEATIU from a distance with the help of engineer Jose Segovia, one of her sons-in-law, who became the third university president of FEATIU. Diplomas and other documents that need to be personally signed by Doña Victoria were brought to Vancouver by Mr. Fritz Segovia, who currently is the chief executive of FEATIU. She will always be remembered as the first woman to head a bank and a technical university at a time when women were only given the role of homemakers. Without a doubt, our founders are the epitome of integrity, accountability, patriotism, equality, and scholarship. These values are the guiding principles of FEATIU up to this very day. To the next 75 years, may we always strive to keep the legacy, vision, and aspiration of our founders, which are deeply rooted in faith in God, in the love of country and people. May these propel us to keep our vision and ambition high with our feet planted on the ground, to pursue our dreams, succeed in life by continuing to grow spiritually, intellectually, socially, and build a better Philippines for the Filipinos. So we all together soar to greater.